Hello, my dear friends. This is Cross Stitch with Luda. In today's video, I will show you my whips and I will show you my plans for September. Also, I want to show you some purchases and presents. So let me start from my first whip. This is Sampler Cove, company called. Yeah, this is company name Sampler Cove and name of the sampler Midnight in the Garden. I'm almost done with this sampler. As you can see, I have to finish the top part of the sampler and I hope it will take me like a couple of days, maybe 3-4 maximum. And yeah, it will be finished, my first finish in September. Actually, I did not have any finishes in August, I think. And what I change in this project, I start to use my marker to see what I've done and what I have to complete, because before I was tracing this chart with the pencil and it was really hard to see what I stitch already. But now when I use marker, I'm making bigger progress and also I don't do mistakes as before. I want to show you this work closer so you can see it better. And let me remind you that this is 36 count linen. I can't remember the name, but I think it's ivory or cream. It's not pure white. And I think you can use any other color for this sampler because it will be just as good on natural linen or raw linen, my two favorite colors as well. But I love all the colors. Also, I'm stitching with the Madeira silks and you can choose any other color if you like. It's not necessary to stitch what they say. And yeah, so far I like it. And I stitch with one thread over two. I love the borders. Sometimes it's a little bit boring to stitch it, but I love the result. It's really, really pretty sampler. And I know lots of you wanna stitch it as well, or maybe see my finish. And by the end of this sampler, I will tell you how much threads I've used to, and you can buy if you would like the same amount of threads, because they don't say how much you will spend. The reason why, because people change the colors. Sometimes you can stitch it with the darker and this is with lighter one, and do whatever you like. But I like what I have. Maybe you can stitch it on a 40s count or even smaller one, but I think 36 is perfect for the sampler. Also, you can stitch on 28 count, 2/2. It will be just as pretty. So this is my first whip and I'm happy with my progress because I did not stitch this sampler for a while. Maybe the last time I stitched in spring, I think, if I'm not mistaken, I can't remember. But it's really, really easy cross stitch work for me. My next project is my balloons. You've seen it just a few weeks ago, I think. And I need to complete my right upper part, which is basically all half stitches. But I'm a little bit tired from this work because I was stitching it for a long time and I just need a break before I finish this work. But I think September is a perfect month for this design because I would like to have some finishes. And by the end of the year, my plan to have as much finishes as I can. And that's why I'm planning now all my whips which I have to finish, like half, or there are smaller ones, because I would like to have more finishes this year, because I was focusing on larger pieces and it takes really so much time, whereas you stitch simpler and in 1 or 2 weeks you can have a finish. This one I stitch for almost 2 months. Yeah, 2 months. If you are new on my channel, this is a design, how it looks like. Balloon Glow by Nikki Boimi. Also, if you are new on my channel, please pay attention that my channel is in Russian and English languages. I try to make them the same, but sometimes I just don't feel to repeat same things over and over again. That's why you can see some videos are different, just a little bit. So my next project I just started last night, and this is Mirabilia. Also, the reason I'm stitching it now, because I would like to have a finish, and she's very, very next to the end. And this is Mermaid of the Pearls, number 26, MD26, designed by Nora Corbett, and this is out of print chart. I got it long time ago, and this is the correct price, you can see, because it was on sale. And I will not show you the whole thing, because I was recording my videos about all my whips, and you can see she has a large tail. But now I'm working on her foam, and I will start do her skin one over one with pitted point, and it will take me like maybe 5 days, maybe less, I hope 3. I'll try, I'll see. And then I have to add beads, and here lots of beads, because all this part will be full of white beads. So she has her hair and her tail everywhere. But it's really pretty design, as you can see. I use my needle minders from Kim. Sometimes I use just plain ones, and when I wanna bring more inspiration or to inspire myself, I use these magnets. And this is my third whip for month of September. And I have other plans as well, besides these three whips. I hope I'll manage to finish the Just Nan Caesar roll, because it's really a small design, and I started already last year. And not sure I will complete the whole roll, but I would love to finish stitches at least. I think it's possible, because it's really a small design, and I was showing you in my whips as well. I think I'm here somewhere, yeah. So I will be focusing on this part. This is my plan for September as well. If I will have time, because remember, I have to finish my dimensions and my sampler cove. It will be like maybe 10 days, then Mirabilia. And today is what, 10th? Can't remember which day, today is Monday. And if I will have maybe 1 or 2 days, maybe more, I'll be working on my icon from Thea Gouverneur. It's my second icon. And I just have this part done. Again, I'm not opening the kit, because I just show you in my videos about my whips. If you have not seen this video, I'll leave a link below. Please have a look. And I was really thinking to finish this design by the end of the year, but because I don't have much finishes, and this will take me another maybe 2 months to finish it, maybe less, but I don't know. This part is a really difficult one, and here also lots of confetti, but this part is easy. Oops, there is a magnet here. So this is my plans for September. As well, I would love to frame some small work. I have like 3-4 designs. I don't know how many I will frame, but they're very, very small. I wanna add them to my wall where I have all the small designs. I'm not sure about butterfly because of the circle. I wanted to make a box, but now I changed my mind. I think I will just frame her and she will be great on my wall. But this, I would love to frame. I remember I started stitching her, this design in May. I was in Bulgaria and I started this design. It's pretty. But I think before I wanted to stitch on Aida, but now I think it will be better maybe on linen. I don't know. But it's still pretty, I still like it. I will see when I will frame. Also, I finally finished completely this design. I add this dragonfly. Also this design on Aida, and I think it's okay for this piece because it's a full coverage. You will have just a little bit for your mat right here, but yeah, this one is fine. And this one also I would love to frame, and here I decide to leave a butterfly instead of a dragonfly because I put them together and I like butterfly much more than dragonfly. I would like to make a black mat for this design with a white line by the, on the ends. I'm sorry, right here. I don't know how to say it. And then black mat. Yeah, but it's beautiful, beautiful design. So this is it about my whips and plans. And now I'll be showing you my purchases. Okay, this is my second part of the video, my cross-stitch stash. It's my favorite part because I love shopping and I love cross-stitch kits so much. Same like I do love some charts and accessories to my hobby. And let me start from this kit. This kit was long time is out of print, and recently it was printed for Russia, and you can buy some of them in Ukraine. I was thinking, do I need it or no, but I remember how much I wanted all that out of print cross stitch kits, and this one is a really pretty one, in my opinion. And I decided, okay, let me get it, because I was like in the mood to buy something. Definitely, if I'll stitch it, I'll be replacing the Aida, because I don't like to see its holes. It's not really a full coverage kit, but honestly speaking, I don't like to replace it, Aida, because you pay for the kit, right? And then you have to throw away this fabric and get some other one, which it is another plus $30 if you order with delivery. So this is my first kit. My second kit is this petite, also was reprinted for Russia, but I've got it here in Ukraine, and this 18 count ivory Aida, I think. Yes, ivory. And this kit was my favorite for a long, long time. And somehow I've got two of them. So one will be as a giveaway for you guys. If you like this one, let me know. I'll ship it to you wherever you live. Rules are the same. And I think in 1 week I'll draw a winner, just because I would love to say thank you for you for watching my channel. Okay, next I'll show you all my kits, and then I'll show you some other stuff as well. I don't know if you know this kit or no, but if you dimensions lover, you definitely would No, this guy, this is Leonardo, and I wanted this kit for a really long time. It was my favorite since Well, I can't even remember. 2013, I think. No, 2014, I could not get it anywhere. And now I have this kid. And this is white count Ida. 18 count, yeah. And all these pretty colors. I see lots of people stitch it, and I was like, I wish I had this kit. And now I do. Who knew that it will be all reprinted? Because lots of people paid so much for all these out of print charts and kits. Because Dimensions had charts as well, lots of charts and charms, and they're mega expensive, some of them extremely expensive. But I do have a chance now to get reprinted kits from Dimensions. I don't know when I will be stitching them, don't ask me, but I need to have them because they were like a long time ago my favorite. Another one is Eagle. Eagle's Eye View. And I love eagles. Love, love, love. My first cross-stitch kit from Dimensions was Eagle. I think it was, what was the name? Bald Eagle. When he's flying and behind is a rainbow with a tree. Anyway, this kit I also wanted for a long time, and I saw prices on eBay. Like, no way, I will never pay this much. But again, now I have a chance to stitch it, and who knows, maybe next year I'll start stitching it. Because these kits will be most likely started next year. I'm not saying finished, but I'll definitely will start some of them. And here is dark gray. What is the count? 14 or 16? Because here I have a stick. Maybe they say here somewhere. I can't see. But anyway, this is number 35117. Looks like 16 count. But could be 14. Not sure right now. I can't tell you. And yeah, this is a winter design, but I think you can have it all year round. Yeah. I don't have desire to start these kits now because I have lots of stuff going on. But definitely they're my favorites. And this one also, white winter lace, is a very, very popular design in Russia. Russia, Ukraine, wherever in our western part of Europe. And lots of people stitch this design as well. And I think it's like classic design for Dimensions. Also, there is a, I don't know why the packet's so wrong. I didn't open this kit, it's closed. But anyway, here is the same Ida. Yeah, I think it's 16. And you can see it's really fresh kit. 05, yeah, May 26, 2019. Beautiful, beautiful. I now have all these super rare Dimensions kits. Not all I'm showing you right now because I'm going to Moscow on 25th of September. I'll get more stuff from my friend because she's keeping them for me there. And what else I've got in Canada? This is just a chart with some bead pack, and also I think it's silks. It must be silks. Or maybe Gentle Art thread. Yeah, Gentle Art. And the rest are DMC. I have to use in this design. 32nd Zweigart linen. I have fabric for this design, so I just need to add DMC threads. Maybe this winter I'll stitch it. Who knows? Because it's a really small design. And again, I did show you this design as well from Victoria Sampler. And I found one Russian lady was stitching it on our floss tube. So I was like surprised to see it again. Okay, that's it with the kids. I've got, oh wait, I forgot another chart. I just opened it just before my video. I keep it closed for a long time. But one of my followers from Russia, her name is Yana, she made me surprised. She knows how much I love Jasmine pins, and I don't show all of them on my videos, but she asked me if I have this one. And I know it was for sale. Well, I don't follow all the cross stitch stores, but I know lots of people got this pin with a chart on kasachinina.com. I don't know where she got this one, but she asked me if I have it, and I said no, I don't. And she like, I'll give it to you. And I'm like, oh my god, I was so happy. And she sent me from Russia. It took like a month. I was like, I hope they did not lose my parcel. And then my mom, like, I wanted to ask my mom to go to the post office and ask them, maybe it's arrived there and it just laying there. And the girl who sent me this kit as well, she like, I was like, was about to ask them, post office people as well. And the same day we got this beautiful, beautiful chart. It's small, but I think it will be gorgeous for my pin cushion. Yeah, because I have lots of pins now, and I need some space. I don't like to keep them all together in my green pin cushion. Sometimes I change them, but I would like to have less, so you can see the design, the actual design of my pin cushion. Also, because I did not glue the top part, I think I might will change it sometime to another design, but I will keep the bottom part. And it will be fun because I can make some winter design. And believe me, this pin cushion always inspiring me, always. I would keep less needles, pins from now on, because it's too much. It looks like I'm a hoarder, but I have much more on my other pin cushion as well. Yeah, but now I'm so, so happy. She made my day, months, whatever. It's so nice to get something you really desire. And maybe next year, maybe this year I'll stitch it. It will take me like one day to stitch. It's really small design, look. And yeah, all the DMC threads. And there are beads here included as well. Here you can see black beads. You'll use in the center of this flower. Cool, really cool. I just opened it. I kept it closed, but I decided to open just to touch the pin. And also have other pins. I did not open them yet, but they're from the Primitive Hair collection. I've heard they're not the best quality. I don't know. I'll check. I'll open them and I'll let you know. Have lots of them. And if I'll see more, I'll get more, just because I like pins. And can't say I will be collecting them, like just then. I just will have them once in a while for my videos, for you, and for myself as well, just to have some good mood. This one is fun for winter, and I think they're great for the, as a present for your cross stitch friend. I think that, yeah, they're handmade. I know they have a sheep. I don't have it yet, but it's not as difficult as just then to find them. And the last one. This is so much fun. Look at this one. So much going on. Yeah. So we're going to my presents now. Well, we started already with my pin. This I've got in a Russian store. Not Russian, Ukrainian store. lady was very, very nice. I like her. And my next big, big present from my favorite kitty. I'll show you presents now. I was super happy. It was really, really hard not to cry, but I think I did a little bit. And again, thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. You are so wonderful. And believe me, I'm still so happy knowing that I have all the treasures. So first of all, when I arrived to Canada, Kitty sent me a parcel and it arrived to old address of my parents-in-law. And some people knew them and they called them, and now I have that parcel. I'm so happy it didn't get lost or returned to her, because otherwise I don't know where I will get it. Anyway, the reason was this kit from Bootsila, and this geisha. Well, I can't tell you that I like her from long time ago, no, but it was my favorite since 2018. When I saw her started stitched right here, one of my friends, she's stitching her. I don't know if she did any progress, but I saw that part, and she said it was really hard to sort the threads, because I don't think, oh no, here's DMC flaws. So I just need to use, yes, I'm right now. I just have to use my chart, which I have. It won't be as difficult as other Bootsila kits, because it's kind of new. I mean, the newer Bootsila kits, most likely they use DMC threads. And number of this kit, 45950. So I open it. I was about to start stitching it, and I look at all the threads, and I look at the organizer inside, and I'm like, no way, I will make mistake and I will regret it. So I will start it next year for sure. I'm happy that they have what is Murana, what kind of fabric they use here. But let me show you the colors, because I opened it, I was like staring at this puzzle for at least for 3 hours, and I was like really itching to start something new, and I did not have anything I would stitch besides my dimensions kits. And I can't say I'm tired of dimensions, no, I'm not. I'm just tired from same design I stitch. I needed some break, something to stitch, because I would stitch more than I did, but because I did not have any other designs, I had to stuck with one. I didn't spend all my time with that kit. But look at all the colors. I might will sort them when I will have mood. And this fabric, I saw the chart, it's not as big, but there are lots of backstitch, and you have to change your thread quite often. But when it will be stitched, it will be amazing design with my kimono I stitch and the one I have in progress now. It will be really nice. And another geisha I'm stitching from Lanarte kit, it will be great. Love them, love this designs and threads and everything, treasures. Also, Kitty gave to me something I'm not gonna show you right now, guys, because I first wanna collect all the other parts from the design, and then I'll keep it secret for now on. But maybe you saw that and you will know my secret, but I just wanna first collect the other parts and show you all together. So next thing she gave to me, this linen called Russian Tea Cake. I like the name. And this is 37 count. I never stitch on 37 count. And I will definitely use for my designs, because I don't have some plain fabric. I always have Picture this plus for my mermaids. I have big priority, and honestly, that I have all the fabric for some designs I collect. I kit it already, so I don't have like free fabric. Sometimes I want to start something like that, like this design. I would love to start. I have some leftovers, but if it's bigger, again, this is a pin add to my collection. I need to open it. Maybe I will start stitching this autumn. Why not? It's just a small design. Also, you use only DMC threads. I forgot to show you in my purchases, but this was from a Canadian store in Nanaimo. Okay, we're now talking about Kitty. I just forgot because I was making video for Russian floss tube. So this design, this fabric will be great for my some primitive designs and maybe some sampler stitch here. I don't know. It will be great to stitch even sampler cove. Midnight in the Garden on this fabric. It will be amazing. I think it will be perfect on it. But I'm stitching now on cream. Just an idea for you. Next thing. This was like, wow. I did not tell Kitty, but I did not even dream about these charts. I saw them once on eBay. Then I saw them second time. I saw them third time, I saw the price, and I did not even look at them anymore, because I know that I think winter or one of them extremely rare. Two of them you can buy for ridiculous price, but another one I never even saw. I know one of these charts is super rare, and there is no spring. Also, I wanted to ask why there is no spring, and Kitty sent me a letter for a few pages, and I read it many times, believe me. And also she said if she will see me selling them on eBay, she will be disappointed. No, I won't. It's my present, and I will be stitching on a copy. I will keep charts. I don't know what to do with them, to be honest. And but this is my gift, and I'll keep it for myself, probably, most likely, yes. I will not give it as a gift to another person, because I don't think it's right. And I was like so thrilled when I saw them, because it's something you don't even dream about. So thank you very much. I know they're really, really nice and beautiful. And if you don't know them, first of all, it's a blackbird designs. This is how they will look like at the end. You can stitch them separately without the border. But because I like a series and I love collect everything, I'll stitch it together, and it will be amazing with my blackbird sampler, the one I stitch and I show you before. I forgot the name of this sampler, but there were 12 parts I stitched together. Yes, this is gorgeous, gorgeous. I love blackbirds. I have few designs. I got the charts, but some of them I don't have threads, some of them I don't have linen, as always. So next year I'll be collecting threads and linen, hopefully. This is, will be my focus for what to spend money. And slowly, slowly you can buy threads. And yeah, I don't think you have much to stitch, because they're not difficult. It's not dimensions kit, you know. And every single chart has another piece on a back, and I would love to stitch it as well, because I really like blackbirds. Everything, believe me. There may be very few designs I like, maybe won't stitch, but I like them. And if you notice, every single chart from blackbird have beautiful pictures. I don't know who taking those pictures, but I think these scissors I've got because of the blackbird design, and they become super popular after. I think they call Elizabeth. There is another Elizabeth, but the smaller one. But this one is really nice scissors to use. They're comfortable and they're working amazing. And I love this tulip. I have another tulip from blackbird design, also out of print. And this gorgeous board must be stitching by me. I like her. Either it will be a picture, or maybe I'll do a box as well. I'll see. And I have, I like how she write me in a letter about how I keep my, exactly, Kitty, exactly what you said, it was true. I do keep my projects in my grocery stores. It's sad, huh? But it's true. Yeah, but this is a bag for me. And I'll be using, I used it already when I was traveling from Canada. I put my stuff here and the gifts from Kitty, and I'll still have a letter from you. Actually, the stuff you sent for Paul, we will be using. And we will show in our video. He's traveling now, so when he will be back, we will show you our report. Also have another small stuff from her, and this is small cross stitch notebook with a sampler. It's so cute, it's so cute. I'll be write some notes here, it's for sure. I have my first cross stitch notebook. I write there when I started my kids, when I finished them, and after I begin my YouTube channel, I stopped write every design, how long I stitch, when I started, when I finish it. But I think, not I think, I promise myself I will start doing this again, because sometimes I'll show you video later than I finish, and I don't do pictures in the same day when I finish my design, not like before. Before, when I like started my Instagram, whenever I finish, I have to take a picture same day. It was like not even a question, it was my desire. But now I only take pictures when I want to. For example, today I took a few pictures of my work, of my work is in progress, and if you would like to see them on pictures, please go on my Instagram and you will see detailed pictures. So, because all of that, I don't have a track of my designs, how many I stitched, when I stitch, and I have to put everything in order. Maybe I will do it all over again in this notebook, because it's super fun and super cool, and I think it will be enough till end of my life to write here. It takes like few lines for each design. Look. Maybe I will do that. I'll let you know. Also, what I've got from Kitty, it's it's super cute. This is a scissor fob. And I have to change my scissors now because they're not as sharp as before. And I'll use some silver scissors. It will be great together with my favorite full heart. I see this design right here, Shepherd's Bush, Caesar Fob. It's so cute. Thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. It was so nice to have every single part from your puzzle was exactly what I love. I can't explain to you how grateful I am. And it's always, always happy to see your messages and letters. So next things I've got from Jasmine, there are just few of them, they're not extremely rare or whatever, and I might stitch them once in a while because they're small, and you know, when you stitch big designs, it will be nice to just have a rest and stitch something to have a finish. This one with the original, how you call it, forgot the name. It just came out of my head, but anyway, you all know how it called, like I'll remember after I turn off my camera as always. And this is Bunny Biscornu. I think it will be great for springtime to have on my table. And this one I most likely will stitch now, I don't know, I'll see. Acorn. Okay guys, I forgot. It's time for me to go and do some work, and later I'll be stitching, uploading my video, and I will post some pictures on Instagram, and I will be now thinking what the thing called. I'll turn off camera and I'll check in my phone the name of the stuff. Okay, thank you very much for watching me. Please subscribe to my channel and like this video if you enjoyed, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye, guys.